What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Two Phones, back again with another informative video. This video is right on time, and it's about the iPhone 6 1 week later. Now, for my usage and my experience, I'm going to just be honest. It's been cool, okay? It's been cool. It's been like, I wouldn't say man, but it's been like, okay, like a normal use, like a person that really doesn't care about the bells and whistles of all these other devices that's out on the market that can actually do more than what the iOS or iPhones can do. But I know the new iPhones are more superior and they can do all this and this. But if you just want a simplicity device, I would say go with a cheaper iPhone. I would say go with a lower end model iPhone, like the iPhone 6, iPhone SE, something that doesn't really get too much in the way of what you just, you know, want the basic use of a smartphone to do. But now if you want to get into all that extra stuff, like really super multitasking, then you'll want a Galaxy device or a Motorola device or, you know, an Android device that has more bells and whistles than your typical iPhone. Not talking about the iPhone 10, talking about something that's older than the iPhone 10. Now with the iPhone 6, I can't lie, this has some great idling. When I mean idling, you can sit the phone down on the table, just let it sit there. You could be, you know, doing something else, maybe even sleeping. You could be going to sleep, taking a nap, something in that particular, cleaning, doing the dishes, and you can check your phone, and the percentage stays like maybe 1% killed or something like that in that particular sort. But for my usage with the iPhone 6, I put it down on the table, put it on my dresser or something like that, away from me, right? Away from me. It's not a distraction. It saved a lot of battery versus my Moto G6, which drained like maybe 4 to 5 to 6% even overnight. I'm not sure it's because the apps are running in the background or it's because of the Android system or what have you. Even the Galaxy S9 would drain more than 1 or 2%. So the iPhone 6 is still superior in the battery idling. Now, I can't say on, you know, when you're using the phone, yeah, you're going to see your percentage drop. So I even kept my percentage. I even turned on the percentage of the battery on my iPhone to see how many, you know, percentage I'm dropping. And I did see it drop while I was, you know, watching some YouTube videos, going down my Google Plus list, or, you know, hitting a few people up in Google Hangouts, iMessaging. I seen the battery drop a little bit. So it depends on your usage of the device and what apps you got running in the background, what apps you don't. So that, with my experience with the battery life, I really didn't have to charge it that much, and I'm very impressed in that. Another thing I want to talk about is the size of the phone. Now, the iPhone 6, I think, was one of the biggest iPhones that, you know, Apple dropped since the iPhone 5, since the 4.5s and the, you know, 4 inches and the 3.5. So I think this was like one of the first phones that got the bigger screen, and with the iPhone 6 Plus, you know, with the 5.5 or this is like 4.8 or something like that. So, and it's very thin. I mean, it's almost as thin as my Moto G6. The device is very thin, so it's very lightweight. Sometimes I forget it's in my pocket. I do have a case for it, so this does keep it protected. I'm trying not to use no case on the iPhone. I think I could be very careful with this device. I mean, it only costed $99. I could easily replace it. So, but the size, and it's just thin. It's like real light in the hand. Also, for viewing videos, it's not that bad. It's really not that bad. I'm kind of shocked I can get used to it again, like the smaller screens. Whereas, you know, I got the S9 and the Moto G6. They got bigger displays. The 18:9 ratios, that make a difference too. When you're watching media, like from Hulu or Netflix or YouTube, that makes a big difference. But I really didn't see any black bars. So, like, I don't know, maybe because the phone is black, it's got a dark display on the front. And yeah, I took it back to the old wallpaper. I took it back to the OG wallpaper for the iPhone. So that's my wallpaper on my display on the iPhone 6. So the display isn't that bad. I mean, for it to be 750, I think 720p, something like that. It's not that bad. And I think that's why it was such great on the battery life. Okay. Okay. So the sound isn't the best. The sound quality on this iPhone 6 isn't the best, but it can get you by. If not, just put in some headphones. Shout out to the headphone jack, man. Shout out to the infamous headphone jack. I just use my AKGs, you know, and I tune out. Now, I do have Apple Music, so I use Apple Music for the rest of the year on the iPhone, and I signed in with my account, and I put it on my S9 and my Moto G6, so now all my Apple Music is on my Android and iPhones, which I'm glad Apple kind of like, you know, allow Android users to use Apple Music, because that would have been kind of bogus, but, you know, I rock out, I got my own playlist going. I got rock music, I got pop, I got trance, I got electro, hip-hop. So I got all that going, and the sound quality, it varies from device, man. So if you want the best sound quality, you got to go with the best phone. And like I said, I love the S9, but iPhone 6 is still killing the battery life for some reason. I mean, yeah, I can scale down the S9 to 720p, but once again, I'm going to hear all these users, why would you do that? Why would you want to do that? Well, if you want battery life, that's what you're going to have to do, because the iPhone is killing it in there, all right? So that's what I wanted to talk about, again, with my 1 week later usage. Another thing is memory. I don't know. I really haven't been playing around with the memory as much. I know that I still got like, what, 4 gigs of iPhone storage left, because once again, I use the OneCloud. I use the iCloud and OneDrive and Google Drive. So all my videos, if I shot any videos on the iPhone, or if I shot any photos on the iPhone, everything going to the cloud. Nothing's on the device itself for apps I downloaded. So that's a good thing. And the music that I downloaded also would be loaded up to the iCloud and so forth. So I can actually, like I said, whatever music I listen to on my phones, I can listen to it on the iPad, the tablets, or even my PC, which I got iTunes on my Windows. So in a way, you can still be in every platform at the same time. It just depends on how you use your devices. But I've kept around 3.5 to 4 gigs of free storage on my device. So the memory is good for me. Memory is good even on a 16 gigabyte phone. But if you're a user that don't use the cloud, then you will need more storage. But since I'm more techie and all that, I can manage that. Okay, now another one I want to talk about is the calls and texts. Now, calls and text quality, the call quality, I don't know what Apple is doing. But for my usage, even on FaceTime, I did FaceTime. I made some calls in the TextNow app. I made calls on Freedom Pop or on Calling app. And it's all been like clear. So I don't know what they're doing in the calling or audio department when it comes to the iPhones. But it's just like, why can't we get that on Android? That right there is, I think that's why a lot of people use iPhones, because the call quality is good. It's really good. I'm not even gonna lie, it's really good. When it comes to iMessage, since I don't have a quote unquote real cell phone, I use my iCloud or I use my email to use iMessage. But the messages, like, it'll show you that, oh, it's been delivered, it's been sent, stuff like that. I'm trying to think, do I get green and blue bubbles? Let me double check that. I think it's the blue bubbles. So I see why people, you know, get headaches about that, but at the same time, I'm not being picky, because majority of the people I talk to don't even hit me up in the iMessage. They hit me up on Hangouts, Facebook, WhatsApp, Telegram. You got all these other messages. I don't get anybody hit me up in an iMessage. Maybe like one or two people. But I have a whole gang of people that use Facebook Messenger, that use Google Hangouts, that use Telegram. Shout out to Easy Computer Solutions Group. But this is why we can't depend on the quote-unquote universal messaging, because it would never happen for the simple fact all these other messaging apps that quote-unquote call themselves secured and more superior, and you could play videos that don't get scaled down and things like that. And I know a lot of people said that the iMessage don't scale down video clips and what have you. But iMessage, it's okay. It's okay. I'm not saying it's GOAT or whatever like that, but it's okay, because people on Android don't have iMessage, okay? We have all these other things. We have the Samsung messaging app, Verizon messaging app. I think AT&T got a messaging app. So you have, when it comes to Android, you got carriers with their messaging apps, including TextNow and Freedom Pop. And actually, Freedom Pop app, it's been working. It's been working. I haven't had any issues with the Freedom Pop app for calls and texts on the iPhone. Now, I haven't, set it back up on Android, but that's what I'm going to do and test out some theories right there when I get into my full Android versus iOS. But right now, I mean, it's like I said, it's simple. It's just simple, okay? It's simple, and I get it, and I understand it, all right? For cellular connection, now, I really haven't lost a real good amount of signal. Like, some places I've been only had, like, one bar at AT&T, maybe two bars at AT&T. Then there's other places that I didn't even expect to get all four bars on the iPhone. I've got all four bars on AT&T LTE using the Freedom Pop SIM card on the iPhone. So, I guess I haven't traveled far enough yet to whether or not, I lost signal on the iPhone. Oh, I'm trying to, search for signal. So, I haven't gotten that far. Or maybe AT&T has actually worked on their signal. I haven't had any issues on the cellular connection, okay? For Wi-Fi, I've used Wi-Fi, but then I didn't use Wi-Fi because I wanted to test out the whole cellular setup on the iPhone. So I tried to stay away from Wi-Fi as possible. But Wi-Fi isn't bad on the iPhone 6. I did speed test. I don't know if I did a speed test video, but I do a speed test video for the iPhone, Wi-Fi, and download. So that's coming soon. It's been on par with every Android device I've gotten and used so far. It's been on par and close to them on Wi-Fi. Now, when I tried the data, that might be different, okay? As we know, Samsung Galaxy S9 was spanking the iPhone 10. If you haven't seen them videos, go on YouTube. Don't hate on me. I'm just going by what I've seen and what I've used. All right. My S9 on Sprint LTE Plus was getting close to 200 megabytes now. So, hey, what have you? That's here in the hood. That's here in the hood. So, hey, it might go ballistic in the big city. So who knows? All right. So that's my take on the Wi-Fi connection on the iPhone. Now, for gaming, I think I talked about this in one of my other videos last week. But the gaming, of course, I can't play Fortnite, but I played all the other games like Crossy Road, Cut the Rope. I played Minecraft. I played even Asphalt 9, and the games have been great. All right, the games have been great. Okay, games run just fine. The ones that can play on the iPhone 6 run just fine. Now, media consumption, like I said, I think that has something to do with the battery life. Like I say, I mainly be on YouTube videos, or somebody send me a video on WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger. I check them out on Telegram. I check them out. Really haven't seen any, I really haven't seen any bad things about the media consumption, other than if you want to get good sound, you got to put in headphones or Bluetooth it to a speaker or something like that. But, okay. What I really had gripes about the iPhone is none of my cards that I have, debit cards and stuff, are not compatible with Apple Pay. So I really haven't had a chance to get with Apple Pay yet. Another thing I really didn't like is how I do extra work. Well, I must remind you all, I'm still using iOS 11, so that might be the issue. I haven't signed up to the iOS 12 beta. I'll probably be working on that this week. But sending like videos or sending photos, sending files and stuff like that, to me, it feels like a little headache. All right, it feels like a little headache to me using the iPhone on the iOS 11. We gotta do so many sign-ins, and then you gotta go swiping through your section of where to send it to. I mean, if I had AirPlay, then that'd be different. All right, that'd be different. Multitasking, I feel like iPhones are still not superior to multitasking. My thing with multitasking is I like the dual screens or the dual apps, like in S9, Moto G6, where it's automatically, I got two apps open at the same time. I can tweet, I could be on YouTube, or I could be on Facebook, I could be, you know, watching a video or something like that, or texting somebody, and maybe be in a video chat with somebody else. I can do that very good on Android, whereas I can't do that much on this iPhone. That's why I think it's still lagging behind when it comes to multitasking. And I like floating widgets and floating apps on Android, like when it comes to Facebook Messenger and my TextNow app. I got chat heads, so I don't have to leave the app. I could be on Instagram or Snapchat texting or, you know, chatting with somebody, and I can still be checking out, you know, other messages or even emails. I can still be checking out emails and other messages. Whereas on iPhone, I can't do that. I can't do too much like that. So you got to come, when you think about it, you have to think about it from an Android user perspective when you're trying to, you know, use the iPhone. See, now I'm going back into this iPhone versus Android thing, but it's just simple, okay? You just want to use one app at a time, get an iPhone. But you want to use more than one app, you want to have like four or five apps open, and you want to get stuff done, you want to read, you want to watch something, use Android. But for a simple user, a person that don't want the bells and whistles, iPhone 6, iPhone SE, stick with those type of phones. Don't go with the iPhone 10s. Don't go with the Androids. Just if you want something simple and you want a smartphone, all right, then go with a phone like the iPhone 6 or iPhone SE. But like I said, I'm really not dissing the iPhone 6. Like I said, I'm still at 62%. Let me turn it off Wi-Fi real quick. I'm still at 62%. I charged it up like last night. It's like 1 o'clock here in the afternoon. I charged it up like last night. And right now it says I got 3 bars of LTE on AT&T. So give or take, it just depends on your usage. Depends on what you try to do with your smartphone devices. And I say still pick up an iPhone 6 in 2018. I say still get one, man. You never know. Still get one. I mean, it's an OG now in the game, but it's still killing some Android phones in 2018, man. All right, this is my take on the iPhone 6. 1 week later. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. It's your boy, Two Phones.